ओम श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः गुकारस्तुंधकारो वै रुकारस्तन्निवर्तकः अंधकारनिरोधित्वात् गुरुरुत्तभिधीयते। ओम सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ओम शांति शांति शांति। श्रीहरिं परमानंदं उपदेष्टारमीश्वरं व्यापकं सर्वलोकानां कारणं तं नमाम्यहं। अपरोक्षानुभूतिर्वै प्रोच्यते मोक्षसिद्धये सद्भिरेव प्रयत्नेन वीक्षणीया मुहुर्मुहुः। स्ववर्णाश्रमधर्मेन तपसा हरितोषणात् साधनं प्रभवेत् पुंसाम् वैराग्यादिचतुष्टयम्। ब्रह्मादिस्तावरान्तेषु वैराग्यं विषयेष्वनु यतैव काकविष्टायां वैराग्यं तद्धि निर्मलम्। वैराग्यादि चतुष्टयम् पुंसाम् प्रभवेत्। दिस फोरफोल्ड क्वालिफिकेशन नेसेसरी फॉर गेनिंग अपरोक्ष ज्ञानम्। फॉर मोक्ष, मोक्ष मोक्ष सिद्धि, गेनिंग मोक्षा इज गेनिंग दिस इमीडिएट नॉलेज ऑफ द सेल्फ एविडेंट आत्मा इज जगत कारणम ब्रह्म। द कॉज ऑफ द एंटायर जगत ब्रह्मन is myself alone, the self-evident me. It's a very big thing, it's an equation. So this knowledge is sadhanam, moksha is sadhya, purushartha is moksha. What do I want to accomplish is freedom from being small, insignificant. That freedom is the very nature of myself. Therefore, what I seek is freedom. What I gain, what I pursue is self-knowledge, not freedom. I pursue self-knowledge. So between self-knowledge and freedom from being small, there is a connection. Otherwise, there is no connection. What is the connection? Self-knowledge is freedom. So gaining self-knowledge is gaining freedom from being small. The self being limitless. Self is already limitless, and therefore gain of self-knowledge is gaining of freedom. But the purushartha, what I want, is that freedom. The struggle is not to become limitless. Nobody knows what is limitless. But nobody wants to be small and insignificant. Therefore, wants to become significant, dyes the hair. Or, so buy a dyed wig, okay? So, or some kind of wig, okay? So what I say, so dyes the hair. That is all significant. To become significant, what can you do? Nothing you can do. So people are after something, and that something leads to something, something, something. Really speaking, what they want is to be free from being small, being unhappy, being insecure. This is what they want. They want to be secure, want to be happy. The security is the nature of the self, because it's not bound by time, bound by space. Limitlessness is the nature of the self. And therefore, so the whole pursuit is the pursuit of self-knowledge. The pursuit of the nature of the self without knowing. And therefore, the knowledge is the sadhanam, the sadhya is moksha. That is why he said, moksha siddhaye aparokshanubhutihi mumukshubhihi vikshaniya muhurmuhu. So very clearly, it was all pointed out. Then vairagyam, viveka, etc. So here it tells this vairagyam. This is a typical way, their way of talking, okay? I don't talk this way. Brahmadistavaranteshu. You know, beginning from Brahmaloka. Brahmadi sthavaranteshu. You want to become Brahmaji, or you want to reach Brahmaloka. Brahmadi sthavaranteshu. From Brahmaji to sthavara, to a tree or a mountain. Vishayeshu. This is how it is. A to Z. Alpha to Omega. A to Z. This is another way of saying, with reference to all things, lokas, objects, worlds, spheres of experience, objects of experience, status gained, they will all be all ends that the people can seek. Believers, non-believers, all of them. believers in different religions also, all of them, they are all seeking lokas, heavens and all that. All these are between Brahma Loka, or the position of Brahmaji, position of the creator, Brahmaji Hiranyagarbha. And up to any stavara. Stavara means any object that doesn't move. A mountain is a stavara. A tree is a stavara. This is an expression. Alpha to omega. Brahmadi stavaranteshu, Brahmadi stamba paryantam. This is how we talk. From Brahmaji to stamba. Stamba is a stamba of a tree. Stamba also is a worm. So, Brahmaji to a worm. So, there are all expressions. Brahmadi sthavaranteshu vishayeshu. So, vishayeshu, to all these objects, vishayeshu, Brahmadi sthavaranteshu, yata kakavishtayam, Tadhi vairagyam nirmalam. So I feel little, embarrassed to talk about this. But then, kakavita. So, what is your attitude towards anything dropped by kaka, a crow. And so, what kind of attitude, what do you want out of that? Nothing. So, yataha kaka vishtayam, vairagyam natural to you, so too, vairagyam dispassion towards all objects, brahmadi sthavaranteshu. So, that means, you have understood so much, my God. Your viveka is so much. Your discrimination, it is not disenchantment. It is discrimination, the height of discrimination. Your height of discrimination is such that you don't think any end is worthwhile pursuing. Because it is all within the time. Within time, anything is insecure, anything is anityam, anything is finite, you are different from it, and anything gained is subject to loss. Any samyoga is viyoganta, any gain is until it is lost. Either you lose, you lose what you have, or you are gone. What you have may be left behind to your brother-in-law. You are gone. You build a dream house, and then by the time you had the grahapravesham, you enter into the grahapravesham on this day, the next day the fellow had a heart attack, he's gone. Dream house, what is the use of dream house? To whom does it go? It's okay. That I go away is okay. It's okay. It's not a problem. My going away is okay. But who is going to occupy that house? That bothers. So little more volume. So this is tadhi nirmalam vairagyam. So nirmalam vairagyam. So that is, one is kakavishta and this is nirmala. That is mala, this is nirmala. So nirmalam vairagyam. This is pure vairagya. This is the height of vairagya. Means it's not a very big thing, really speaking. You can have different ends. No exaggerated opinion about any end. Because life is full of small, small ends. You have to pursue, even suppose you search for your lunch, a sandwich, there's an end to be accomplished. You go to Subway, you know. And therefore, so you get a sandwich. So this itself is an end to be accomplished. We are not talking about those things. Similarly, there are so many small, small ends. But these are all very objectively pursued. No an exaggerated value for any of them. But real end, living my life, the real end is only one end, achieving which there is no further end. That is the real end. What is the use of pursuing? If the pursuit continues all the time, you gain an end, then again you continue. Gain an end, you continue. Gain an end, you continue. What is this? What is this pursuit? Without any end to the pursuit. The endless pursuit. So the endless pursuit will come to an end only when the end is not separate from you. If it is separate from you, the pursuit will be endless. And if it is you, then that you should be, what do you gain should not be separate from you. And that is the only possibility of the limitless. The limitless alone will be endless. And the limitless cannot be separate from you. If it is separate from you, it is limited by your being, not that end. And therefore, the limitless minus you is limited by you. You limit the limitless. And the limitless becomes limited. And naturally, there is no limitless. See, silly argument. The limitless is you. Only way, that is the only way to be free from this endless pursuit. Very simple. And therefore, vairagyam. So when you parikshya lokan, nirvedam ayat brahmana. A viveki, when he or she analyzes, experiences, understands that any experience is time bound. Experience hunter is a samsari. Understand, any experience hunter is a samsari. He comes to the spiritual field, then also he becomes an experience hunter. I want to experience Brahman. As though Brahman is an object. I want to experience Brahman. Brahman is the truth of every experience. Brahman is you. Brahman is the very truth of the experiencer and experience and what is experienced. All the three of them are Brahman. Understand? Brahman is cognitive. It's not different from experience. The very anubhuti. ವೆರಿ ಅನುಭವ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಸ್ವರೂಪ ಎನಿ ಅನುಭವ ಈವನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅನ್ಹ್ಯಾಪಿನೆಸ್ ರಿವೀಲ್ಸ್ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮನ್ ಆಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಸಸ್ ಆರ್ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮನ್ ದಟ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮನ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಹೋಲ್ ಟೀಚಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ಹಂಟಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಂಸಾರ ರೆಕಗ್ನೈಸಿಂಗ್ ದ ಟ್ರೂತ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಎನಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಸ್ And every experience is knowledge, is liberation, freedom. If that is understood, Vairagya is very natural, correct? This is called Vairagya. This Viveka leads to dispassion, experience hunting comes to an end. Hunting experience comes to an end. Experiences continue. Hunting experience, hunting for experience, special experiences comes to an end. Before knowing the vastu, this much of discrimination, viveka must be there. Viveka and Vairagya, two sides of the same coin. Next is Viveka. Nityam Mat. ಸ್ವರೂಪಂ ಹಿ ದೃಶ್ಯಂ ತದ್ವಿಪರೀತಕಂ ಏವಂ ಯೋ ನಿಶ್ಚಯ ಸಮ್ಯಕ್ ವಿವೇಕೋ ವಸ್ತುನಃ ಸ ವೈ This is called Viveka. Born of which is Vairagya. Nitya Swarupam. Nityam Atmaswarupam. Atmaswarupam hi Nityam. Atmaswarupam eva Nityam. Object of experience is time-bound. Drishyam Anityam. Anityam. Tat Viparitagam Drishyam Anityam. Drishyam, object of experience, is time bound, is within time. You need not say Drishyam and it is Anityam. Drishyam Chet Nashyam. Yad Drishyam Tan Nashyam. Drishyatvat दृश्यत्वात् घटवत्। एनीथिंग ऑब्जेक्टिफाइड बाय यू इज अनित्यम, नॉन इटर्नल, टाइम बाउंड, दृष्ट नष्ट स्वभाव। द वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग थिंग, दृष्ट नष्ट स्वभाव। दृष्टम मीन्स पास्ट पार्टिसिपल, दृष्टम मीन्स देर इज नो रियल, दृश्यम इज दृष्टम, स्वामी इज दृष्टा, इज ऑल द टाइम दृष्टा 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 दृष्टा। यू डोंट सी Swami right now. Whom you are seeing? Swami of the past. How can you see language? How can you see the past? In fact, you see the past. Big Bang Theory is because of your seeing the past. A light coming from 12 billion light years away is seen by you today. See, you are seeing a light that started traveling 12 billion light years. Means traveling 12 billion years away, not 8 years, 12 billion years away. Light traveled 12 billion years lagatar, and you see today, hub. It reached you after traveling 12 billion years. So you are seeing from this earth, part of a solar system, which itself is a part of Milky Way, which was not there before. That was the time you see. That was the light you see. The light started 12 billion light years ago, travel karke is reaching you. So at that time, this solar system was a remote possibility. A remote possibility. Very interesting, you know. It's something like seeing your mother's marriage. Not video, directly seeing. We are doing that. That is a big thing. Now you see the Swami, you don't see the Swami. You see the past Swami. Drishta. See, Drishta means seen. Drishyam is the object of sight. Drishtam means seen. You are seeing. Drishta Swami. Swami Drishtaha. Drishta Swami. Drishta Swami is Nashta Swami. Nashta means gone. We have seen, gone, seen, gone, seen, gone, seen, gone. Because you pick up the light reflected by this body, the reflected light, your eyes pick up. For the eyes to pick up the reflected light, the light has to travel and reach the eyes. Correct? That light has to travel to reach the eyes. If the light travels and reaches the eyes, it will take some time. Correct? It will take some time after all. And light travels 180,000 miles per second. 80,000 odd miles per second. So in that speed, the light has to reach your eyes. It will take some time, some small length of time, fraction of a second, a microsecond, fraction of a microsecond. Takes time. Therefore, there is no present at all. All your present is only past. Anything you see, therefore you see the Swami you had seen, okay? You see the Swami of the past all the time. Drishta is Nashta. This is called Drishta Nashta Swabhava. Anityam tad viparitam gacchatiti viparitagam. That which is opposed to nityam, anityam, drishta nashta swabhavam, drishyam, every object is drishta nashta swabhavam. Every object, it is seen means it is gone. In fact, gone alone you see. Correct? Therefore, don't expect anything permanent in this world. You need not have permanent things. The only permanency is for you. This is a nishchaya. The nishchaya is half nishchaya. If you understand totally, it is not qualification. It is knowledge. Therefore, you understand this much. There is nothing in the world of experience which is lasting. It is all time bound. Why it is told? Because it is said, you go to heaven, it all started from India only, this heaven idea. Veda talks about heaven. And somehow this idea went around. If Veda is an ancient body of knowledge, this idea has been there. Either it went from Veda or elsewhere also it is known. This idea is there, there is a heaven. And it is desirable. There is consistent happiness. It's pleasurable. Without buying a ticket, you can have dance music. And it goes on. And you will have a proper frame of mind to enjoy that. Suppose you go to heaven and you don't have a mood to enjoy all this. Say, what is this? Always dance music. There is nothing. Then it's useless. It's useless. So you will have an appropriate frame of mind to enjoy whatever that is offered to you in the heaven. Very beautiful. So you have the right frame of mind and object of experience. This is heaven. And you can buy a ticket locally here. There it will be the hawala deal. There you will get this. You buy the ticket here, and this ticket is, you do something good, good actions, do some charities and do some prayer, etc. You will get some ticket. So this ticket will take you to heaven. So of course, it will be turned into, it will be translated into experience. This is heaven. Correct? And there is no old age there. There are no core issues also. Because childhood is not there. You start your life with a body ready to go. This childhood and all that upbringing and then dysfunctional home, all this nonsense doesn't exist. There is no unconscious. So you have a body, ready to go body. Correct? So enjoy the world. This is wonderful. Therefore, a lot of religions promote this tourism. Heaven tourism. It's a tourism. All religions are promoting heaven tourism. Honestly. You want to go to heaven? After death, you want to go to heaven? Tourism, promotion. This is called religion. Because every religion should promise me an end. And the end is tourism. After death, you will go to heaven. After death, tourism. Okay. All right. Then, the Veda tells, same Veda, which promotes this tourism, quietly tells, don't have this idea that once you go to heaven, everything is over. Everything is not over. There again, you have got degrees of pleasure. Your joy is measured. Because there are other fellows there who would be more comfortable and more, they are more capable of gaining a better degree of happiness. There is also a ruler. Indra will be there. Unka Guru is there, Brihaspati is there. All these guys are there. Therefore, you have to settle for whatever you have. Same thing. This half cup is full. And therefore, this half cup is full, you should be happy. Don't complain about the empty part of the cup. And therefore, complain about emptiness. Talk about the fullness. The half cup full, I am happy. My cup is full. How can it be full? My cup means heart. My heart is full. Why? Because the cup is half full. This kind of thinking. this is donut thinking. This is, you know, donut hole thinking, called positive thinking. You eat 10 donuts and then feel you have not eaten anything. No calories. Why? 10 donuts, no complex. This fellow doesn't want to put on weight, but eats 10 donuts in the morning. And he has no complex at all, no guilt. How can he live a guilt-free life? He is a positive thinker. How do you say he's a positive thinker? Having eaten 10 donuts, okay, what kind of positive thinking it is? Hey, come on. Every donut has got two parts. One part is the caloric part. The other part in the middle is non-caloric, zero caloric part. And therefore, so 10 donuts means zero. 10 zeros constitute nothing. Therefore, and all these negative thinking people, what they do? They eat one donut and worry about the calories. The positive thinker, 10 donuts, and he counts the holes. There is nothing. It's called positive thinking. This kind of thinking there also I have to think. In order to be happy there consistently. Because you'll be comparing the other fellows. Naturally. Therefore, heaven also, even though there is a better standard of living, and there are no bacteria there, and so there is no disease, there is no old age, and there are no core issues, very inviting, but still, taratamya will be there, upadhi taratamyam, the type of body you have has got its own limitation, and therefore, so there are better placed persons in the heaven to command a better degree of happiness, and therefore you have to settle for what you are given, correct? By positive thinking. This is one problem. And don't think you can live permanently there. It's only you have done some finite karmas here. Good karma you did. How much good karma? How many good karmas you did? Karma phala. So the result of karma for so many years and some good karmas. So they produce some finite karma called punya. This punya is translated into everyday experience. You pay from that punya, finite punya. Every day, one day gone, count down, understand? Punya gone. One day gone, punya gone. Another day gone, punya gone. Third day gone, punya gone. Fourth day gone, punya gone. A few days gone, punya gone. Then what? No punya. Kshine punye, martya lokam vishanti. Therefore, this yata iha tata amutra. So how it is here, so it is going to be there also. The laws are the same. Yata iha tata amutra. The laws don't change. Yata iha tata amutra. Just as here, so too there also. Therefore, you will be back. Nothing is accomplished. choir one, small and insignificant, and they're small and insignificant. And therefore, nothing great accomplished. Huh, you can talk about, I went to heaven and came back. Yesterday I went to heaven and came back. You can talk to some people, I went to heaven and came back. Came back, that's all. Like holiday people, so having done holiday, hey, did you have a holiday? Look so different. Yeah, I went to Hawaii for a few days. Huh. Hawaii? Where did you go? Waikiki, you know. How is Waikiki? Oh, it's marvelous, nice sun, everything was wonderful. Talk about it. Without talking about it, it's no good. If you can't talk about it, what is the use going there? Suppose you go to Hawaii and get lost in Tibet, and there's, you know, nobody to talk about. You must come to New York, and people should ask you, and that too in winter, and they should ask you, where were you? Where were you? I went to Hawaii. Play it down. Play it down, as though nothing happened. Play it down. That's a trick. Same thing. Heaven going is the same thing. The Veda that talks about heaven really belittles the fellow who has got any plan to go to heaven. Hey, come on. Think little better. Yata iha tata amutra. The Veda tells, yad yata iha karma chito loka kshiyate tat tata amutra punya chito loka kshiyate. Just as here, your body that you brought along with you is gone in time, there also it will be gone in time. No matter where do you go, you will have only a sojourn. It's a holiday out. Holiday in, holiday out. That's it. Kaam ho gaya. And therefore, you are no better. Brahmadi stavaranteshu. All the lokas, any number of lokas you can go. Loka means a sphere of experience. Any sphere of experience will be found in time and place. And therefore, anityam, it's not going to solve the problem. Nothing wrong being anityam. But it will not solve the original problem of my seeking. Therefore, I will continue to be a seeker. So if you take yourself seriously, I'm a seeker now, I'll be a seeker then. What is the big difference? Seeker now, seeker later, seeker middle. You are a seeker in between. What you had gathered only some biographical sketches, some more data to write your biography. If I read your biography, really it is nothing. All biography is nothing. I tried, that's all. I tried this, I tried that, I blew it, I got an opportunity and I missed it, and I did this water. Then if you can remember all the lives, various bodies that you have taken, your biography will read little more interestingly. In fact, everybody's biography will be just the same. So at one time or the other, everybody was a crab, okay? Everybody was a crab. And therefore, everybody has to write about the crab life also. That is the biography, autobiography. When I was a crab, everybody can write that. When I was a crab, what happened? I was not lucky. Why? Had I been born in India, I would have survived, lived my full life. I was a crab in Hong Kong. So what happened? I ended up in the kitchen of this restaurant. And I was hanging there in a bottle. And somebody named me. So I want this crab. And this fellow was from America. And he came there to Hong Kong and named me. I want this crab. I ended up. I hope I will get a chance of this, to eat this American as a crab. So we eat each other. There is nothing big. All stories are silly stories. There is nothing. All stories are interesting. All stories are the same. This is called Viveka. Understand? And therefore, so, Drishyam, Sarvam is Anityam. This much is enough. Then if everything is anityam, the only fellow is constant in all of them, the invariable in all variable experiences is dear me. And now here the Shastra tells that the drik, the seer, the experiencer, is really nityaha. Atma Nityaha. Really, Atma, the experiencer, the Swarupa, the very nature, the truth of the experiencer is not bound by time. Nityaha. Not only Nityaha, he is the one that you are looking for, the fullness, the freedom from smallness, the fullness, ananda, the limitlessness is the very nature of Atma. The Shastra, the book tells. But one thing is clear, that everything what I go through is anityam is very clear. Atma Nityaha, the Shastra tells, that is acceptable. I am going to discover how. This is called Viveka. This is Viveka. Nityam Atmasurupam. Evam, in this manner, Yo Nishchayaha. This conclusion, this understanding, this much understanding, this is what we say, discriminative understanding, I cannot discover nityam, what is not time bound, in any form of object experience. Therefore, what the Shastra says, that you are Nitya, that is, I think, to be understood. Iti yo nischayaha, and that is called samyak vivekaha savai nischayaha vastunaha samyak vivekaha. That is indeed proper viveka. That I should go to heaven is improper viveka. That I will find a solution somewhere, improper viveka. One day I will come to the truth, I will stumble upon truth. No, you will never stumble upon truth, because you are the stumbler is the truth. The one who goes about stumbling around is the truth. You will not stumble upon. You need to choose to know. This is samyak vivekaha. You have to choose to know. Therefore, viveka and vairagya are the two among the four. Then we have shamadamadi shatka sampattihi. Shamam, damam, uparati, titiksha, shraddha, samadhanam. Iti, a sixfold. The sixfold, so disposition of your antakkaranam. This also one has to know. These are all certain things one must have. Certain disciplines, certain capacities. So these are all talked about. We will see that when we come back. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Avasishyate. Om Shanti 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 Harihi Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om. One more thing. Two things we have to say. We have a